And car approaching, Stewart. Wow, this is the Toyota Sera. I think I'm saying that right. You gonna are you gonna come up here? Or are you gonna stay there? What are you gonna do? I know it's
actually Dave. He told me a long time. I said Sera too one time.
Oh, Sera?
It's Sera, like K Sera,
okay.
Sera.
Okay, gotcha.
I would have never known that if I had not been corrected one time.
So this has a lot of things in common with some design legends, and a friend of mine was letting me look at a very cool book, and it's about the McLaren F1 and Gordon Murray and the whole story of it. And there's actually a page that shows the Toyota Sera that Stewart designed when he was at Caltech. He didn't think this was going to be a production vehicle, and they ended up making a relatively small number of them, only sold in Japan, if you notice it's right-hand drive. And the design for the door, it's very distinct. It's not a gull wing, and it's not one of those scissor doors, and it's not a conventional door, certainly. This influenced the doors that ended up in the McLaren F1, didn't they?
It did. Yeah, Gordon actually put it in the book about the F1. It's great. Yeah, they were trying to figure out how to get the driver into the center of the F1, so the door had to go into the roof a lot, but a conventional gull wing would still be in the way. So, I mean, it was a good solution. But the design brief for this that I got at Calte was, it was to use very humble Toyota Tercel mechanicals, a little 1.5 liter front-wheel drive drivetrain, but to be a very expressive small coupe with some innovative features. That was the idea. And the real story behind this is that Toyota was working on developing a brand new industrial process for metal forming. And can't say much about it except hydraulics were involved. And so they didn't want to take a mainstream program, you know, something like the Toyota Camry.
Yeah, they don't want to say, hey, let's do this on 400,000 Camrys.
Right. and risk the program. So they had a small manufacturing center near Tokyo that crafted these cars, and they made them, I believe, from 89 till 94, about 5-year run, and they only made 5,000 a year, only for the Japan market.
And just so people know, this is not a car out of a museum that was borrowed, this is your car.
Yeah, Nancy and I imported this from Japan about 7 years ago, so it's really fun to drive, you know, it's just a neat little car, so thank you.
And
yeah, Stewart, though, I want to, when you talk about the forming of the body, I have a question. So I see a seam maybe in the sill here. Is that whole rear section one piece, or where is it? How'd that work?
Yeah, well, I mean, they were looking for alternative ways to form metal without using conventional stamping. And so there are some real tricks in it. I think there are some seams lurking in this that have been joined and finished, but
and how much is that, you know, you as a designer, it's like, hey, here's what a car would look like, it's really cool, and you draw something, and then someone in engineering says, we can't possibly make that. So that's one of the things you learn as a car designer.
Yeah, but I mean, there was some real courage on Toyota's part to manufacture this even in low volumes. I mean, to do the things it did with the glass So, you know, this was a 1990, and it's actually the same color as the concept model that I took to Japan, silver blue. So we're real happy to have it. So.
Yeah, now, why did you pick this color? Because I'm always interested in you guys as designers, and the cut, because I know silver's like, it's you know, it's like the default color for design, and this color's a little bit different, obviously.
In the design studios, we love silver because it's sort of this wonderful thing that models the surface and shows contour the best. And like all the studios in Southern California, you take a silver model out, particularly in low morning light or evening light, it's spectacular, you know, understanding the forms. But this color is because the concept model that I took from Calte to Japan was this color. So that's why I got it.
You know, also like silver, apparently attorneys in Century City, when they make junior partner, they have to get their BMW in silver. That's like a rule, I think. Well, Stewart, thanks for bringing it up. This is very, very cool. And it's got a relationship with the McLaren F1, which I should have bought one of those when they were new. I thought about it. Apparently that would have been a good investment, the McLaren F1.
Like one of the best investments,
yeah,
right?
No kidding.
Yeah, seriously.
There goes.
Other than Fangio's 250 Grand Prix car that was.
Umbrella でも飛行機でもない。もちろん普通の自動車でもない。飛んでるセラ登場。ガルウィングのセラ。愛しているのさ、狂わしい幅。
Toyota Sera.
それではここで全く新しい車セラの技術開発レポートをご覧いただきます。まずガルウィングドアを開けるとき雨が降り込むことが考えられます。さまざまな実験の結果最も気になるのは 直接の雨よりむしろドア表面を伝わって落ちてくる雨滴です。この雨滴の侵入を防ぐのが T バーブのレインガターです。この幅は雨滴の侵入防止と室内からの開放感をバランスよく両立させたものとなっています。また雪への対策も考慮しています。例えば走行時にルーフに積もった雪は室内温によりシャーベット状に滑りやすくなっています。このような状態で停車しドアを開けるとこのシャーベットが室内へ落下してしまいます。このためドリップチャンネルの設定や見切りシールのリップ形状の工夫により室内への落下を防止しています。また極めて稀なことですがドア周辺の凍結によりドアが開かなくなるという現象も確認されています。そこで凍結した氷を剥がれやすくするためドア下端部に見えているゴムのシールが施されています。ゴムの弾性によって凍結時も容易に氷の剥がれるきっかけが作られます。グラシーキャビンという性格上真夏時の快適性についても十分な検討を行いました。もちろんセラはオートエアコンも標準装備の上ブロアモーターの容量もアップしています。しかし冷房性能という面では外部からの熱をいかに低減させるかが最大の課題です。そこでルーフ部に脱着式ルーフサンシェードを標準装備しさらにはバックバイザーも用意いたしました。この他にも全く新しい車セラを快適に乗っていただくために様々な工夫を凝らしています。ぜひ一度お確かめください。